Hey, Jim. Take a look at this. Just popped up on my computer.
It's a top secret file.
I didn't even know my security clearance went that high.
You're right. You barely have any clearance. This is heavy duty. This is the type of stuff that the Pentagon boys read as bedtime stories.
Well, what's it going on intelligence reports?
I don't know. It says something about an Operation Suspect device. Probably just something the military brass is dicking around with.
I don't know what it is.
I'd say it's no more than a fancy mousetrap. Don't worry about it. Didn't happen.
Dr. Ferguson, how long after the accident did you examine Dr. Travis?
About an hour and a half.
And how would you describe her condition?
Agitated, disoriented. Most of the time, she didn't even seem to know where she was.
And you took a blood test at that time?
Yes, I did.
What did you find?
She tested positive for amphetamines.
And would you describe for the jury how that would contribute to her disoriented condition?
As opposed to being intoxicated, Dr. Travis's behavior was a result of sleep deprivation, combined with a drug that causes prolonged central nervous system overload.
Objection, Your Honor. This is highly speculative.
I'm looking forward to tomorrow. Good night, Judy.
Good night.
You.
Meet Sam.
Oh, hi.
Oh, Daniel. Julia's told me a lot about you.
Really? She doesn't know that much about me.
She could have fooled me. Listen, I heard you had Dick Stanley in today.
How did you know that?
Sam uses 54% of his brain.
Dick Stanley's a good man. Quiet. Excellent.
Very quiet.
Julia, see you tomorrow.
Yeah, thank you.
Mr. Hill, if I may. Look, you've got the money, but I can't give you a loan without a doctor at the clinic. He's a doctor who needs your sound finances. Mm-hmm. So why don't the two of you become partners?
Why don't I roast my tongue with a welding torch?
Lonzo! Teddy! Oh, my God, how are you doing?
Oh, man, good to see you.
Oh, I can't believe this. Fresh snow and now Teddy Hayes.
I cannot believe I'm lucky enough to find you here on Christmas Eve.
Oh, well, we're heading to the mountains. Teddy, I'm sorry. I'd like you to meet my new wife, Carmen. Carmen, this is one of my oldest friends, Teddy Hayes.
It's a pleasure to meet you.
It's my pleasure, Carmen.
So, what is it, Teddy?
Oh, man, I got a problem.
Oh, how can I help you?
Well, actually, desperate is a better word for it. My attorney has disappeared, and I have to be back in court in an hour.
Court?
Yeah, I still own the travel agency, and I booked some people on an overseas flight for the holidays. They got bumped. So now they're suing me for their expenses and damages and everything.
Oh, well, man, that's a shame, but, I mean, we're heading off to the mountains.
Alonzo?
Yeah, we got to go, though.
He's one of your oldest friends.
Well, he should have came to us first.
Gives us an excellent opportunity to give something back to our community.
Yeah, but are you sure this is going to work? I mean, aren't telethons for a disease?
Works for PBS.
And who pays for the studio?
Don't need a studio. We'll do a remote for my dad's church.
Your Honor, four witnesses and 20 minutes of videotape confirms the defendant's presence in intensive care after visiting hours during the weeks in question. He's guilty of trespassing, Your Honor. Prosecution rests.
Thank you, Mr. Rose.
As you may or may not know by now, we've lost contact with A-14, one of our launch control facilities at Ellsworth.
That facility controls 20 Minutemen 3 ICBMs.
Each with a 1.2 megaton nuclear warhead. We received a distress signal and then nothing. Override is inoperative.
System malfunction?
Yes, there's a billion to one chance of that.
Dad, it's for you.
Oh.
Some woman named Claire.
Who is she? Just a client, son. She has a case just coming to trial soon.
Oh, no wonder she sounded so nervous. I'm going upstairs.
Okay. Why are you calling me here?
I called you at your office. They said that you left early.
Why are you doing this? Suppose Helen had answered this phone.
Well, maybe she should have.
Yes, that would have been lovely, wouldn't it?
I need to see you, Paul, now.
I can't see you now.
Why not?
I just can't.
Well, then tonight.
I can't see you tonight either. My son has a basketball game tonight.
Ah, oh, well, we all have our priorities.
Listen, it's the city semifinals.
Is that supposed to make me feel better, Paul? I can't wait forever to see you. This is driving me crazy.
Listen, Claire, I can't talk to you. I'll call you tomorrow.
Oh, with what, another excuse?
I'm tired of being your mistress, Paul.
You keep telling me that you love me. When are you going to do something about it?
Something like what?
Like, get a divorce. You said that you were going to. You promised me.
Listen, now is not the time to discuss my marriage.
Well, then let's set another time. I'm free all week.
Claire, listen, I've got to get off this phone. I will call you tomorrow.
Liar.
Miss Wagner, this is Lieutenant Briggs. He'd like to ask you a few questions.
Miss Wagner, first, what are CSATs?
California Scholastic Aptitude Tests.
They give those tests to seven-year-olds?
His IQ was estimated at 180. And I say estimated because we don't have the ability to test any higher.
It says here that he was expelled from school. Why was that?
Well, he was always fighting. That time, he pushed a little girl off a swing. Her arm was broken.
Detective, check out girl's parents. Miss Wagner, why did you let a violent kid back into your school?
You're going back to college, son? Where?
Spring with you. The basketball coach, he gave me a tryout last weekend. Well, I made the team.
Did you play basketball again, son?
One of the greatest comebacks of all time.
Oh, son.
Don't get too excited, Dad. I mean, there's no scholarship involved. I have to take a part-time job.
No, don't worry about that. I'll take care of all of that. You just concentrate on your studies and on that jump shot. Not necessarily in that order.
Well, close to an 11 o'clock curfew, so better to say.
Can I down? Jason. I love you, son.
I love you too, Dad.